Here in the lightning round, lots of things to talk about. Let's start with Jay-Z. He says he'll move forward with his holiday partnership with luxury retailer Barneys New York, which has been accused of racial profiling two African-American customers at its Manhattan flagship store. So should he go ahead? Okay, let's just take the temperature in the room. Dee Dee?
This is silly. I mean, look, as far as profiling, I mean, that's what you do in retail. I mean, I think if the word is being used incorrectly, I think it's overblown. If it wasn't, Jay-Z would not go forward. If he really thought that was the deal, he's a business guy. You know, the department store's in business. So I think it's much ado about not much.
Okay.
I would just say, at least if I understand it, the two main people complaining were both African-American. So why is it that those are the people who have been stopped and accusations have been made against? Why aren't they frisking and watching after and stalking white people?
Well, I'm not even sure if that's even the debate. A lot of folks are just debating whether Jay-Z himself should go forward. So
it just seems, I agree with Dee Dee on this one because I think it's just over the top. I don't see Barney's being discriminatory.
No,
that's
of course
the last
not.
Thing.
They want to sell stuff.
But there was a conspiracy theory on this one also that they were trying to create a little more to the story to create a little more
publicity. Well, that might be. They may just be making it up. I don't know.
It could happen that someone profiled a particular customer because they didn't think that customer could really afford the item. That could happen.
But by the way, it's not right. You just don't know that, though.
Yeah, but it's not right. But that doesn't mean that the store is discriminatory. The whole company's discriminatory. It's just not a good one.
Uh-oh.
I want to say, though, we are probably more or less all white people staying around.
Well, more or less, yeah.
More than less.
I'm the whitest.
We don't have the experience, probably none of us do, of going into a store and routinely being stalked or watched or checked out or not let in the store because of the complexion of our skin.
I can actually say that I have experienced that. My brother, who is much darker than myself, I have absolutely experienced that. On the Hispanic side, so.
But I'm saying, imagine if that happened to you. If you're a dark-complected African-American male and you're tall, and you're in New York and you want to go in the store, and you almost can never be in a store without someone following you around. It's insulting. It's humiliating.
Don't go to the store. I'm sorry. I just think it's overblown. What are they doing? They're following them around. They have, by the way, newsflash, they have security there to follow everyone around.
What about a pattern and practice?
But you don't know that.
I don't see any pattern and practice.
It presumes that an African American is any more likely to steal from the store than
a
white.
You don't know that, though. I think it's unfair to the business to just assume that. I mean,
but
their job
is
to keep. There's lots of shoplifters.
I think maybe better training on some people.
I think so, because you don't want to have someone working in the store going down this aisle of profiling, if you will. Okay?
And they're a bad run-across. They are bad. They just want to harass everybody. You know, that's not good.
All right, we're going to go on to our next debate here on the lightning round. Well, there was a fight for bragging rights this week, if you didn't hear about it, for the tallest building in the United States. Is it One World Trade Center with its 408-foot antenna, or is it the Sears building? We all get to vote right here. Dee Dee.
Oh, it's New York for sure. Forget Chicago. No way. And I love Chicago. I love the Midwest. I'm from the Midwest. But you got to give this to New York City. Just, you know, for the symbolism of it alone. I mean, World Trade Center, yes, of course, is number one building. And you know what? It's a big, like, hey, you people, guess what? You didn't get us. We're still alive. We're still going strong.
This is much ado about nothing. Moreover, I'll vote for Chicago.
No way.
I got my two graduate degrees from Chicago, and that building is big. It doesn't look that good, but they didn't have to add this. You know, this whole thing is about these cities having edifice complexes.
You said you had a psychology background too.
I think the psychology on this one is really not too much. I like what Dee Dee says about New York. I'm a little biased about New York myself, but I think there's much to do about very little.
I just thought it was just more of a fun debate.
I have to say that I am
from New York. And spent every summer in Chicago. Mm. So I was torn on this one. But, you know, if you were to say, is it an antenna?
Mm-hmm. But who ultimately cares? I mean,
well, they get to say it's a good little tourism thing.
Who cares which is the biggest building?
Oh, we all care. Come on.
We're here for fun.
New Yorkers care.
They say that women don't care about size. Why should we care?
Oh, my
about
God.
Size?
On to the next one. He admitted to smoking crack cocaine, partying with prostitutes, and he's been yelling obscenities. Well, now the Toronto Council has voted to strip their mayor, Rob Ford, of his powers. Now, this guy is so bad that I actually think I love him. So he's just, he just keeps doesn't stop.
No, he's a gift to us because he's really mentally imbalanced. My view as a psychologist is he brings up many other issues here. What do we do when someone reaches this type of position? How do we get them out?
But be
because
careful,
there has to be a way to get somebody
there
out
is.
Who is not mentally sound.
Is he a network? You may not be paid for yourself. You're sitting in the making a diagnosis from the
chair.
Well,
I haven't met him, but I have pretty good ideas about him.
That he's in network?
I don't think he's imbalanced. I just think he's crazy. I mean, I think there is a difference, too. Like somebody who's just that way, they're very strong, they may be obnoxious, they may be rude, terrible, but
Who are the voters? Maybe they were the ones that
his popularity's gone up.
But
it's like Clinton during the height of the Monica Lewinsky thing.
I don't believe his popularity went up.
Let's hear that for 1 second.
I said that during the height of the Monica Lewinsky thing, Clinton's popularity tended to go up. But people like a bad boy up to a degree.
I don't think they like him. And I think that if you watch his press conferences, he doesn't make sense.
I think he's hilarious.
He doesn't.
I'm sorry. I just think it's funny. It's so entertaining.
But here we go again.
Here's the thing. Has he done a good job? For the most part, yeah.
We go back to the debate that you and I
Wiener,
have had.
Right.
Yes. Between Spitzer and Wiener.
If he does a good job, I really don't care.
Argument is always like, well, if you make that elementary mistake, and a fundamental mistake like that, then I don't think you're smart enough to be in power.
Yeah, but Bill Clinton made the same mistake with Monica Lewinsky.
It was a bad one, but he was still a good president.
I call that the oral office where he operated there.
Oh, wow. You're so bad today.
It was right next to the Oval Office, and we know what he did there, right? And the country gave him a pass. I couldn't believe it.
I actually can't believe that either, though. I can't believe the women gave him a pass.
Isn't
there a difference between crack cocaine and behaving in a certain way and an affair? I mean, there is a difference, I think.
Well, first of all, crack cocaine is illegal up in Toronto
Good point.
It's
really bad. It's bad role modeling. That's what it is, really.
It's illegal. It's the same thing as Spitzer. Spitzer did something illegal.
Right.
And so if you're doing something illegal, it's different than immoral
Wiener,
and
too.
Illegal.
What he did was illegal.
I don't believe.
Send my genitals through the internet if I want.
He didn't do anything illegal. He really didn't. I mean, it's okay to do that, but it was really bad behavior for sure.
Okay.
But this mayor has demonstrated though a particular personality type that, in my view, does not represent what a mayor should be. And I think the people understand that.
Well, now it's such a distraction. He can't do it anyway. It's such a distraction that
council,
he can't operate anyway.
Well, the council voted him out anyway as of today. So. Yeah.
Oh, they are voting him out?
Yeah, they did. I think it was a pretty much of a landslide, the 39-3. Don't quote me on that because I don't have that.
So now what he does is he'll be on Donald Trump's show and he'll be fired by Donald Trump.
I don't think Donald Trump wants him.
He doesn't have a winning personality. He's got a day on Jerry Springer.
I don't think he's got the winning personality.
Donald Trump can get his ratings up, he'll do anything.
Okay, we're going to show you some photos because the National Geographic 2013 is going to have some of its most wonderful photos. And if you want to send some of your entries, you can also do that, nationalgeographic.org. And you can see some of them right here. They are absolutely gorgeous. I just can't get over some of these.
I'm not sure exactly, but
look at that one.
Beautiful.
And you know, just the appreciation just for art, just to see this, and I just wanted to share some of these as we ended the show.
That's when you like Mia.
That's the one that I like. But look at that, just to be able to capture that at the exact moment that lightning was striking.
Ooh, I love that.
I like the lightning.
That's your favorite one.
You can do that with a really fast thing on your camera, so it may not be such brilliance on the part of the photographers we'd like to think. I mean, brilliant photograph, but.
But still, to be out in the elements, I mean, I always have to say to any of the folks that we work with in the media, the folks that are out in the elements to capture some of these pictures, just absolutely
There's
remarkable.
Nothing better.
Again, it's the 2013 National Geographic Photography Contest. You can still enter it up to December 3rd, and there you go.